Hello, everyone. Je suis très heureux d'être ici ce matin avec les ministres Haidu et Anand, ainsi qu'avec la Dr. Tam et le Dr. Niu. We have a lot of ground to cover this morning, so let's get right into it. I'll begin with vaccines. This morning, I visited the vaccination clinic at the Nepean Sportsplex here in Ottawa. It was great to see more and more people getting vaccinated. People were in a good mood. A lot of folks were there with their elderly parents. Everyone was chatty and focused, but quite frankly, it was the amazing volunteers who were working so hard who really encouraged us all, and we saw smiles on everyone's faces. I also had the chance to chat with a few of the many healthcare workers who are part of this vaccination effort. They're all doing an incredible job during this really tough time. My job as a politician is usually go around shaking hands, so that wasn't the challenge that we got to do. There was a number of older folks who I needed to remind that an elbow bump is the way we do it. But we're all figuring out how to navigate through this, and the fact that so many people are getting vaccinated is a really good thing. Our frontline workers have given up a lot to stay safe. Last week, I spoke to nurses from the Victoria General Hospital in Winnipeg. They shared what this past year has been like, caring for isolated patients in serious situations, sometimes being their only point of contact and holding an iPad or holding their hands through a window while family members watch through a window. It was incredibly difficult, incredibly challenging for healthcare workers across the country, even more so when it comes to the fears that on returning home, they might be bringing home this disease to their families. It's been incredibly stressful, but they continue to step up every single day, and all of us need to make sure we're doing the best we can to keep them from getting overwhelmed and overloaded with new cases. But everything they do makes us the heroes, makes them the heroes of this pandemic. Présentement, notre plus grande priorité est de faire en sorte que le plus de Canadiens possible puissent être vaccinés le plus rapidement possible. Et on travaille sans relâche pour y arriver. À ce jour, on a livré plus de 6 millions de doses de vaccins aux provinces et aux territoires. Cette semaine, on va recevoir nos plus importantes livraisons jusqu'à maintenant avec 3,2 millions de doses. Ça inclut les livraisons prévues de Pfizer et de Moderna, ainsi que les 1,5 millions de doses du vaccin AstraZeneca qu'on va recevoir aujourd'hui de la part des États-Unis. As we've been saying for months, and as we've been planning with the provinces and territories since last year, the end of March will be followed by an increase in vaccine supply. We now have handily exceeded our promised target of 6 million doses delivered before April. And this week, we begin our ramp-up phase. Throughout April and May, 1 million doses a week are scheduled to arrive from Pfizer alone, plus Moderna, plus AstraZeneca. And for June, we have good news to share this morning. Pfizer has now confirmed that they will be moving up 5 million doses from later in the summer into June. That'll bring our total from 4.6 million to 9.6 million doses for that month alone. Of course, that's in addition to the other doses of the Moderna and AstraZeneca vaccines that we'll also get. A lot of doses being delivered means a lot of people who are able to get their shot. If you haven't had your vaccine already, it might be your turn or a family member's turn soon. If you want to learn more about vaccine safety and effectiveness, there'll be a Facebook Live event tomorrow where Dr. Tam, Dr. Niu, and other experts will answer Canadians' questions directly. To attend or get more information, go to the Healthy Canadians Facebook page. Today, I also want to talk about where we are with the virus and what that means going forward. In some places, cases of COVID-19 are holding steady or even going down. And especially in long-term care homes, vaccination seems to be making a real difference in protecting people from outbreaks. That said, hospitalizations from COVID-19 remain high, and case numbers are going up in many regions here in Canada and around the world. Variants of concern, which can spread more easily and make people even sicker, are increasing quickly. In BC, where the number of cases had been under control, they're now having to put in place new restrictions for the next 3 weeks. I want to extend my full support to Premier Horgan and to all premiers across the country as they make tough decisions to keep people safe. As we have since day one, the federal government will have their backs and do whatever it takes to save lives, to protect our frontline workers, and to support jobs and businesses until we get through this. Il ne reste que quelques jours avant le début de la fin de semaine de Pâques, et la Pâque juive a commencé samedi dernier. C'est maintenant la deuxième année de suite que ces célébrations se déroulent en temps de pandémie. Malheureusement, ça veut dire qu'il faut continuer de faire bien attention. Dans la dernière année, on a vu les cas augmenter après d'autres congés, comme celui de l'Action de grâce ou après Noël. C'est très important d'éviter une augmentation après Pâques si on veut continuer le printemps dans la meilleure position possible. Je sais que c'est décevant, mais il faut éviter les rassemblements. C'est pas le temps de voyager. Continuez de porter votre masque, de vous laver les mains et d'utiliser l'application Alerte COVID. La vaccination de masse progresse bien, le beau temps s'en vient, mais il faut continuer nos efforts un peu plus longtemps. Avec la hausse récente des cas dans certaines régions et les nouveaux variants, on ne peut pas baisser nos gardes. Alors qu'on continue nos efforts pour protéger les Canadiens, il ne faut pas perdre de vue que la pandémie a accentué les inégalités à travers le monde et a eu un impact plus marqué sur les populations vulnérables. À ce sujet, hier, avec le secrétaire général des Nations Unies, Antonio Guterres, le premier ministre de la Jamaïque, Andrew Holness, et plusieurs dirigeants mondiaux, on a tenu une troisième rencontre sur le financement du développement. On a discuté de solutions concrètes pour aider les pays les plus gravement touchés par la crise économique actuelle, notamment en ce qui a trait au surendettement et à l'aide internationale. Il faut adapter nos systèmes économiques afin qu'ils répondent aux enjeux mondiaux urgents, tels que la pauvreté extrême, les inégalités et bien sûr les changements climatiques. Le Canada est toujours là pour écouter et pour agir, et on va certainement soulever ces questions lors de nos prochaines discussions avec le FMI, la Banque mondiale, ainsi que le G20 et le G7. As we rebuild from this pandemic, we have to make sure no one gets left behind. Yesterday, Ministers McKenna and Monsef announced $250 million for transit in rural and remote communities. This fund is part of the unprecedented public transit investment we announced last month, and it is the first federal fund dedicated to rural transit. This is part of our job to create jobs and fight climate change. It's also about building more inclusive communities where seniors can get to their doctor's appointments and where people of every age can get the services they need. Before I end today, I want to say a few words about Easter and Passover. Again this year, we won't have the kinds of celebrations we were all hoping for because we just can't afford to let our guard down. I know I've said the same thing before every major holiday over the past year, but this time, what's different is that even if the end of the pandemic is in sight, the variants mean the situation is even more serious. We're entering the final stretch of this crisis. We just need to stay strong a little longer. More and more vaccine doses are coming every week, so there's reason to be hopeful. So please, keep yourself and your loved ones safe. Now is not the time to travel. Avoid gatherings and parties, and continue to keep your distance. I know it's not easy, but together, we will get through this.